Good morning, AHS. I'm Charlotte.
And I'm Jackie. And today is Tuesday, April 27th. Hey, Charlotte, if COVID ended tomorrow, what would be the first thing you would do?
I think I would travel to another country.
How about you, AHS? What would you do if COVID ended tomorrow?
Okay, we're here with
Logan.
And our poll question is, if COVID was 100% gone tomorrow, what would be the first thing you do or the first place you go?
I would start being with my family more because with COVID stopped like us from celebrating parties and family events. So it'd be good to get those back again.
Great, thank you. Good luck tonight. Okay, we are here with
Jada.
And our poll question is, if COVID was 100% gone tomorrow, what would be the first thing you do or the first place you go?
I think I'd definitely go to a concert.
Okay, we are here with
Mary Combs, librarian.
And our poll question is, if COVID was 100% gone tomorrow, what would be the first thing you do or the first place you go?
I would go and do the trips that I canceled last year, so I would probably go to London with my daughter.
Good answer. I bet a lot of people agree with you. Thank you. Okay, we are here with
Zach Dutton.
And our poll question is, if COVID was 100% gone tomorrow, where would be the first place you go or the first thing you do?
I'd definitely go to a concert somewhere like tropical, like California or Florida or somewhere.
Good answer. Thank you. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Okay, we are here with
Paige.
Eli.
Hyatt.
And our question is, if COVID was 100% gone tomorrow, what would be the first thing you do or the first place you go?
I'd go to Canobie Lake Park.
I'll go have a party and concert and basketball games.
Maybe Lake Park.
Where would you go? Portsmouth, New Hampshire.
Nice answer. Thanks, guys.
While school has been difficult for most in the past, high schoolers were faced with new challenges this year when bringing learning to the comfort of their own home. We asked students which they preferred and for what reasons.
Okay, do you prefer in-person learning or online learning?
In-person learning, because you can meet people new and old.
Hi, my name's Jack Mulligan. Personally, I prefer in-person learning just because you get to see other people. And that's always fun. And sitting at your computer all day, that's fine because, you know, I'm used to it. I don't do anything. But being able to see other people, that's why in-person is better than remote for me.
What challenges do virtual learning present with you that you didn't expect to face before?
I just think it's harder to focus when you're at home, when you have all these distractions.
All right. Which do you prefer, in-school learning or at-home learning?
Hands down, in-school learning.
Definitely in-school learning.
Why?
Oh, well, you can't replace the connection with the students when they're in your classroom. It's easier, it's more engaging. I feel like the students are paying attention more. It's just why I became a teacher, not to teach somebody over a computer.
Yeah, you never know if the students are actually there. Nobody uses their cameras. It's better to have the interaction with the kids right in front of you.
Next week, Cohort A sophomores will be taking the ELA MCAS starting May 3rd. Remote students will be intermixed between Cohort A and Cohort B during testing. The bell schedule will be the same for Monday and Tuesday, and Wednesday will be a half day with the day one schedule ACEG.
Andover High School students were asked where do they see themselves in 10 years.
My name is George.
I'm Christian Tompkins.
My name is Daniel Stump.
Zach Ratte.
This is Adi Chunduru.
Okay, where do you see yourself in 10 years, George?
In 10 years, I see myself sitting by my pool with my German Shepherd, just living the life.
I see myself marrying a very rich person so they can finance all of my needs and I won't have to work ever in my life.
In 10 years, I see myself hopefully going to college and being good. I want to be a business major in college and I want to have my own successful business.
I see myself in the NBA in 10 years, bro.
In 10 years, I see myself just having a nice job and hopefully not in prison. Okay. That's the goal.
Like,
I want to be like a teacher, so I'll just like teach people about history and be that like cool history teacher with like the bad ties and like plaid shirts and like, you know, that guy. So
what team do you want to be playing for?
Let's see, anywhere in the West Coast, but if I had to choose, Golden State Warriors, Los Angeles Lakers or the Clippers or Sacramento Kings.
And why do you want to stay out of prison?
Because that does not seem like a fun place to be.
Okay. Are you going to be in Andover?
Maybe not in Andover, but maybe in the city in Boston.
Yes, I will be.
No, definitely not Andover. The kids here are too annoying, so.
Andover High School's theater, arts, and music will be having their spring musical, Songs for a New World, performing outdoors on May 6th, 7th, and 8th at 8 p.m. Tickets will cost $15 for adults and $5 for students at the door. All streaming tickets will cost $15. Patrons must bring their own chairs.
The Environmental Club will be hosting a drive-by event showcasing some of the electric vehicles in our community with the goal of spreading awareness about the benefits of electric vehicles and encouraging people to consider purchasing one as their next vehicle. On April 30th, electric vehicles will be driving from Andover High School to downtown Andover, and anyone is welcome to gather afterwards at Domino's parking lot to learn more about electric vehicles. Some of the participants of the drive-by will stay back in the parking lot to discuss their experience with their vehicles and engage with the public.
Join the Endangered Species Club. They're advocating for endangered animals, learning and fundraising for them to have a better life in future. They want to create a group of students who also share the same goal of helping animals and spread awareness of how we could change lives. Join the club on Instagram or join our Google Classroom with the code on your screen.
Andover High School senior Alex Hazelwood is coordinating a clothing drive and toiletries drive during the first 2 weeks of May to benefit Katie's Closet. Katie's Closet is a local organization that has been a powerful partner with the Boston, Lowell, and Lawrence Public School in providing essential clothing and toiletries to families affected by COVID-19. Please spread the word and ask your family and friends to donate gently used clothing for children ages 4 to 18 and new unused toiletries. Alex is collecting donations on a table at the bottom of her driveway at 17 Knollcrest Drive in Andover. This is a contactless donation site, so feel free to just drop and dash. Make sure to contact Alex Hazelwood with any questions at ahazelwood5@gmail.com before it's too late.
If you would like to work on the AHS Sustainable Garden this summer, please complete an application and submit it to Ms. Cutler by visiting the link on your screen or joining the Google Classroom with the code on your screen. Audrey and Lauren are back with Takeout Takeaways. This week, they try Mr. Gelato.
I'm mad at you guys. Why would you pick Mr. Gelato over Crumble? We wanted gelato crepes, and they didn't have gelato crepes today, and I'm very mad.
Okay, wait. We're getting too ahead of ourselves here.
No online ordering,
which was honestly kind of confusing because you go on their website, they give you the menu and everything, but there's nowhere to order. Online order, which, it, I mean, come on now. That's like a zero. Mr. Gelato is a small space, and on a hot day like today, everyone's here. COVID safe was also, I mean, we were in a long line with a lot of people.
Not very COVID safe.
I'd give it like a four.
Four out of 10.
Well, they had good outdoor seating.
They did have good outdoor seating.
And so that was good because it's a gorgeous day out, and so.
Just a little short clip of us eating outside because it's nice out, so we can actually eat outside. You have to keep this in, Sona.
Sona, don't add this in. That was a big plus.
So I'm texting Lauren all day and I'm looking at the menu. I'm like, oh my God, they have crepes with gelato in it. I'm so excited. Mm-hmm. Like, we'll get something different. It'll be so cool. We get out there. We're like, do you have crepes? And he's like, starts on Monday. I'm like, what do you mean that starts on Monday?
So
I got black raspberry, she got Nutella, they have birthday cake, they have like a Smurf. The gelato is actually pretty good, it's just pricey. I'm gonna be nice, I'm gonna give it a 7.
I'll give it an 8. I mean, it was good. It wasn't like, it wasn't good.
It was just like disappointing because we were expecting them to have something that they didn't. And they have boba, and I like took a video of the menu. It's actually kind of cool. I was just a little confused and stressed out to like order it.
But the menu though, I mean, it's obviously not clear like what they have and what they don't have. Overall, I'd give it like a 6.
I'd give it a 5.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Mr. Gelato. I'm really sorry. I'm not trying to bash this place because it's good and they have cool things. It's just like, if I was looking for dessert in Andover, that would not be my first place.
Always
every poll we put out, you always pick the restaurants that you don't actually want to go to. We wanted to go to Crumble. That's all I have to say.
Okay, we'll just cut it there.
See you next time!
See you next time!
This was a really big call! Bye!
That's all for today. If you're not already, make sure to follow AHS News on Instagram @ahsnews.ma. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next H Block.